Now, this video might piss off a little bit of everybody. So let's go ahead and go with it. Now, people who are in comedic science, people who follow the Anunnaki, whatnot, they will say our truth is written in stone. People who follow these Abrahamic religions, they will say their lives are written in books. Okay, this is a lesson in critical thinking. And the law of polarity of where you vibrate along the scale. When we're talking about truth or lie, when things have been written in books, then yes, I believe we can all agree that it's easier for things written in books to be manipulated, to be changed over centuries and centuries of time, to which we know that the Bible is a book that has been translated over and over again, reinterpreted, rewritten, words added, words taken away, books added, books taken away. We know that this writing has been manipulated and massaged in order to fit the paradigm of those who are in charge. We can all agree on that, I believe, except for those people who believe in this book. They're going to say it's pure, but they don't realize that, especially with Christianity, it wasn't until Origen of Alexander, when he wrote the doctrine that everything in this book is inspired by God, that is when that happened. We're talking second, third century CE. Wasn't something that the first century Christians believed in. Now, our truth is written in stone. What that truth is only the truth of what people believed at that time when it was written. It does not make it infallible truth. Do you really believe that the Anunnaki created man as a slave race? We don't have proof of that. We have what the Sumerians believe. Do you believe that every night Ra is on a boat with Set fighting, Apophis, throughout the night so that the sun can rise the next day? It's written in stone. Doesn't mean it's true. Do you believe that Osiris was killed by his brother and then Isis went, got all of his body with the help of Thoth and then used a phallic symbol to impregnate herself after floating over his ping-ping because she couldn't find his penis, so she put, I forgot the damn thing what it's called, but put that on his ping-ping. It's written in stone. Doesn't necessarily make it true. It's what people believed at that time. The hard part with the Bible is that you don't know what people believe that different. It's telling you what people believe that multiple different times. So it gets muddled much more so than what the carvings or the statues or the tablets show. So the only thing that we can say is we know the truth of what people thought at different times, and we know more truth on the scale of truth and lie of what the people who carved in stone believe than we do with people who wrote in books. So when we're talking about history, we know more about what the Sumerians, the Akkadians, the Babylonians, the Kemetic, the Cushites, we know more about their beliefs and how they live their lives than we know about Christianity. What we know is what people wrote, changed, wrote, changed, wrote, changed. We know exactly what those people thought at the time frame that they thought. So it is more truth to how people live their lives at that time frame and what they believe than it is in the Bible, which is why many people will go to that one as far as if they still feel they have to have some sort of a religion or some type of belief system. But for those of us who don't necessarily have to have a belief system based on what ancient people thought, who look at things like understanding universal energy, understanding the Hermetic laws, understanding the self, we don't need a book, nor do I need stone carvings to tell me what those things. I can look out my window and observe. I can look at nature and how it functions. I can look at how I utilize my law, my mentalism, with the power of emotion and words and thoughts and other energies to manifest what I need, to understand how the law of cause and effect works. But there is no effect that does not have a cause, so I have to be the causation through my will to manifest whatever it is I desire. Yes, those things are written on stone, but they're also written in books. But I have the evidence of proving those things in my life through experience, but also I can see it in others, and that's just how nature functions. If the bird don't flap his wings, the bird won't fly. It has to flap the wings in order for it to fly. That's just how it works, plain and simple. If the moon doesn't move, then the tides don't move. If the tides don't move, then the ocean doesn't have waves. It's cause and effect. We see it happening every day. So always remember, you got to free yourself to be yourself, and your greatness is non-negotiable. Use your mind, think logically, use critical thinking. Good vibrations, good journey.